What up? Good evening. This is Garbage Tier. This is your host, Jamal Baraka, for Garbage Tier Media Reviews. You can check the website out, same name. You can check me out on social media, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, at Jamal is Trash. And I'm your host, and today we're going to be going over an IDW comic that I picked up about a month and a half ago that I just got around to reading. This one is GoBots. I know, everyone's excited. So, GoBots was around in the 80s, and I remember it as being the show that was Transformers-like, but not quite as good. And it was the tail end of the 80s when I remember seeing GoBots, but I couldn't tell you anything about the show at all, other than they transformed into cars and stuff. And even that might not even really be going given much away at all. I don't remember GoBots. Now, this book is by Tom Scioli, and he does the story, the art, and he does all the lettering, and he does a hell of a job. Everything in this book reminds me of pretty much everything I do remember from GoBots, the little memories that I do have. I don't remember any character specifically, but I think he has everything covered. If you don't know Tom Scioli at all, he also did the Transformers G.I. Joe story that came out from IDW, and every character in that looked just like the cartoon and action figures. So this guy's art, his pedigree is top notch, and he does a hell of a translation for this material. I don't know how much research he does, but I think the only comparison I can give for his art style would be Ed Piskor, so doing X-Men Grand Design for Marvel. So if you want a comparison to this art style, it would probably be Ed Piskor. But going back to this comic covers a revolution brewing between GoBots and humanity. One difference that I noticed between the Transformers and G.I. Joe, Transformers and GoBots, is that the GoBots seem to be a group of robots that serve humanity, and it appears they have been created by humans. With Transformers was always an alien race. So right there's a distinction, a clear distinction between GoBots and Transformers. GoBots were made to serve man. So essentially, the GoBots in this series are a slave race, and some of the characters, I know you had Leader One, and then you had Psy-Kill, takes out a couple robots in here. And the story, the action here is pretty good. The art, again, is amazing. The story, for what it is for right now, it's way more complicated than I expected going in. The villain gets notches a kill, and then he has another one that's like really kind of dark. Just reading, I had to read it a couple times, like, whoa, this is a lot darker than I expected, but it's still great just to see. Every page is awesome, and if you are interested in going back and you're on a nostalgia kick or a retro vibe, I can't not recommend the series enough, or this comic enough. Add it to your pull list, add it wherever you need to add it, or come back and get the trade, because it's going to be worth it. Just looking at this first issue, and if you know more about GoBots than I do, or you want to know more, I'm sure there's a lot of sources out here, but this actually made me want to look up the old GoBots cartoons, and I just want to compare it to what I'm looking at in this comic, because there's so much going on here, and there's so much detail in the art. I'm like, wow, how the hell did this not catch on? How is it that we only talk about Transformers, and then you had another series, and I believe that GoBots actually predates Transformers by a couple weeks or a couple months or whatever. So it's not like it was a ripoff. This GoBots was not a ripoff of Transformers, even though it's easy to make that mistake because only one of them is really remembered by everybody. And I do appreciate IDW taking up the time to find this license. This is it looks like we're going to see some stuff, and this is a pretty rich comic. There's a lot of I'm not going to say heavy dialogue, but there's a lot of depth to the script here, it reads like an 80s, I want to say Claremont comic. Chris Claremont from X-Men. It feels like they took time with the script. They're not insulting the audience. The writers, Tom Scully, he knows that his fan base here is pushing 40 or older, and he's not writing this book for you if you were Saturday, you woke up on Saturday morning, you like you're gonna roll over and say, "Hey, I watch GoBots, let me read this comic." No, he's not writing this comic for an 8-year-old. He's writing this book for a 35 to 40-year-old fan that is going back to visit an old friend, and the old friend may not be exactly how you remember him, but you remember that friend a certain way. You're gonna remember them as the ideal of what you imagine them to be. So another example would be if you were thinking about Power Rangers, you would probably have a different idea of Power Rangers than actually sitting up and watching a show. You'll go back and watch an episode of Power Rangers tomorrow and you'll be like, "Whoa, this is trash." But then you'll, in your mind, you'll think back and say, "You remember that episode where Tommy and Jason got into a fight and it was like the most epic thing ever?" And then you go back and watch the episode and they were just walking around each other and then somebody threw a kick and it wasn't really all that. That's what I'm thinking, the impression you would get from reading the GoBots comic. And again, I can't recommend it enough. If you're a fan of giant robots, mechs, Transformers, or you have no experience with GoBots at all, I think you will find entertainment here, especially when you compare this series to mainstream comics. You get a lot of books out here. You can read them in like 30 seconds. You get a lot of books out here. You can read them, and then you'll be like, "Well, damn, that was a waste of money." This one isn't. I feel like even if you aren't really a fan of the story or the characters, you will have fun just looking at the art. I mean, there's a lot going on in this comic, and there's a lot. I mean, you have one scene here where the characters are engaging in like gladiatorial matches and stuff. It's like, I don't know if you guys have seen the movie Artificial Intelligence when you see the robots fighting, but there's a scene in here kind of like that, and it was kind of cool. And just seeing like, it just made me have flashbacks, and I'm really interested in going back and watching these episodes. I saw a couple clips after reading this book on YouTube, and I was like, you know what? If this is available on Amazon, I can see myself going back after reading this book and downloading it or just ordering it and sitting back and just watching it, because I had so much fun. Or, you know, I might even go on eBay and find a Psykill Cycle, because he has a cool design, and he's not as cool as Megatron, but he looks like a cool robot bastard. And I just wanted to see more. I'm invested in this comic because it looks so cool and retro. And we don't, as older fans, we don't get a lot of properties that come back for us. Well, usually when a property comes back from 1980 or earlier 70s or whatever, it's always something that's updated for kids. And when it comes back and it's updated for the kids, the art style looks weird, or it's anime, or it's something that's like really just different, and you're like, "Well, damn, this is not for me." And that's why you get all the complaints that these new IP or these writers, they don't have any investment to these comics or these cartoons or these stories, and you say, "You're ruining my childhood." That's not the case here. This is dedicated to an audience that has working knowledge of this show, maybe even watched the episode, maybe read an old cartoon, and has followed this franchise. So I don't know how big GoBots was. I don't know how big GoBots is. I don't know if this book is selling. I might be the only person reading it, but all I can say is that you will have a great time reading this comic, and I highly recommend it. And go out and buy it, and support your indie comics, and support your local comic shop. This is Jamal Baraka for Garbage Tier Media Reviews, and you can catch me on social media, Twitter, Facebook, Tumblr at Jamal is Trash, or you can check out my website at Garbage Tier Media Reviews, or you can subscribe to the channel. I won't stop you, trust me. We're all friends here. If you want to step into a larger world, you can join our group at The Extraordinary Journey of a Black Nerd, which is also known as Planet EJOBN. We're glad to have you. We have fans and subscribers from all walks of life, and we're over 230,000 deep. So if you have a fan base, we have a fandom for you. Thanks, have a great one, and thanks for spending part of your Saturday with me. This is Jamal Baraka signing off.